At Shell Aviation, we're committed to helping our customers to progress, both in good times and bad. With up to 80% of the world's passenger fleet grounded, this is creating ideal conditions for microbial growth. Here we investigate that challenge and the options available to the airlines.
We'll start off by looking at the different types of microbes. These organisms really require three things to be able to survive. One is a water phase in which to live. So they tend to live not in the fuel itself, but in any water present. They tend to consume the fuel, so they're using the fuel as a food source. And they also need access to oxygen. So if you have those three things in combination, then we can start to see microbial growth. Long turnaround times on the ground tend to accelerate growth. And if we extend that turnaround time on the ground, then we're in the position where we are now with COVID. We're on the ground all the time. We see low utilization as being a trigger for increase in microbial growth. Why do we see it as a problem? Well, it starts to lead to certainly corrosion problems on aircraft. Seals become brittle and they tend to shrink. There's a picture here, especially on the left, which is quite dramatic, of steel. It's not just pitting, that's a hole right the way through a steel plate. And that's due to microbial activity. How do we prevent microbes from forming? That really comes down to the challenge of how a wing tank is built. So on the left, we've got a photograph of the inside of a supply tank, a bulk supply tank. We can design this tank specifically to drain water because it doesn't have to do anything else. If we look to the right, we see what happens once we get onto the aircraft. We've got the equivalent of the tank bottom there in the center of the photograph. So you can see it's now a flat bottom, so it doesn't have a positive sump on it. But to try to deal with that, we try to suck out parts of that low point within the tank using things called scavenge rakes. That should try and suck out any water that's sitting in the bottom of the tank and deliver it to the engine while the engine's operating. Of course, that only works if the engine's operating. So whilst your aeroplane sat on the ground during COVID, we're not scavenging any of that water. Sampling, more than any other fuel property, is really critical for getting good, accurate sampling for microbial testing. So drain points, flexible hoses, sample containers, make sure they're sterile before you're using it. If we start to look at the test kits, then there are a number that are approved through IATA guidance. My personal view of this is if you're going to do microbial testing, it's useful to have more than one technique at your disposal because some of these tests will tell you something and others will be stronger at other aspects of this. What happens if you get an indication on the test that you have microbial contamination? Well, it's common to use in the airline industry one of the two approved biocides. One's Biobore JF, produced by Hammonds, and the other one is Cathon FP1.5. And when we get the results that come from the test kits, we can get different levels of judgment on them. And when we get to that severe or action level, it's really telling you you need to act. And that action can be one of two things, either biocide injection, which is the most common reaction to it, or if left untreated, it might mean that you're needing to defuel the aircraft and then do some tank entry and cleaning. And that microbial testing, you need to understand the sampling methodology, what it is you're sampling, and also the strengths and weaknesses of what the microbial test kits will tell you. But you really need to have a strategy.
This program was specifically designed to highlight the problem of microbe growth and the options available to airlines. This initiative is outside of Shell's core services, but is an area where we have expertise through our own supply chain management. And on a case-by-case basis, we may be able to directly support our airline customers. So if you identify that you have a microbe problem in a particular location, please do engage with Shell and we'll work with you to understand the extent of that problem, what resources we have available and any treatment options, in the hope that we may be able to help you.